Well, hello, friends. Today I am sharing with you the video conference that they had at the president's discussing the the new stance they have on attacks against women or crimes against women. And this particular video, I wanted to share with you a little bit about my the things I found on the internet regarding the acid burns. I'm sure you've probably heard of them before, but this lady was one of the people that spoke at the conference today, and she obviously was had an acid burn. And I believe in the video she said that it happened about 6 years ago. And the person that did it to her has not had charges brought against them. So there's a big push to have the government protect women against the crimes against them that have been occurring. So one of the things that has happened is that let's put this on here. There's been a lot of women protesting, and you know, sometimes they seem to be violent and themselves and doing destruction of public property, statues, etc. But it is good to note that the president has taken an active stance against this behavior of the men. Although sometimes the acid attacks happen to men as well, right? But anyway, I want to show you a few of the things I found regarding this on.
Well, hello, everybody.
On these channels, okay? So I'm going to show you what I found here. And let me see, we've got two. Oops, I hit the wrong button.
En nuestro país se ha adoptado la aberrante modalidad de atacar con ácido a seres humanos.
And so he said, in our country, for the past few years, they've been doing this aberrant act of attacking people with acid.
Manos. Esta agresión se realiza
This aggression is realized
con la intención de desfigurar,
with the intention of disfiguring,
mutilar, pero sobre todo,
and mutilating, but above all,
torturar de por vida,
torturing for a lifetime, or lifetime torture,
dejando a las víctimas muertas en vida,
leaving the victims dead in life, or as living dead.
Como así lo refieren algunas de ellas.
As some of these victims have referred themselves.
Los agresores suelen arrojar ácido al rostro de sus víctimas.
The aggressors throw acid on their victims.
Causando graves lesiones
causing grave lesions
al fundir la piel y exponer los huesos.
As they hit the skin and expose the bones.
Que en ocasiones llegan a disolverse y algunas de las víctimas
which in some cases become dissolved and some of the victims
también pierden la visión de uno
may also or at times lose the vision of one
o de los dos ojos
or both eyes.
Además de las secuelas físicas permanentes que afectan su imagen
and besides the scars that affect their image or self-image.
Las víctimas usualmente quedan traumatizadas psicológicamente por
The victims are usually left traumatically and psychologically traumatized.
De por vida.
For life.
Sufren aislamiento social.
And they suffer social isolation.
Familiar.
Family.
Y su estatus económico se ve afectado por las discapacidades producidas por el ataque.
And their economical situation is affected by the attack.
y las pérdidas económicas derivadas de largos tratamientos médicos.
And the losses, the financial losses from the long-term treatment,
quirúrgicos,
medical and surgical.
De acuerdo a la estadística, el 80% de las víctimas,
according to the statistics, 80% of the victims,
de estos ataques son mujeres.
Of these attacks are women.
La violencia de género constituye un grave problema social.
The violence against gender constitutes a very tremendous social problem.
De acuerdo a la Organización de las Naciones Unidas,
and according to the Association of the United Nations,
algunos países, 7 de cada 10 mujeres,
in some countries, 7 out of 10 women,
sufrirán golpes, violaciones,
will suffer attacks, violations,
abusos o
abuses,
mutilaciones a lo
or mutilations,
a largo de sus vidas,
during their, the term of their lives.
Con base a datos oficiales en México, se han registrado aproximadamente 14 ataques con este tipo de sustancias.
And in Mexico, we've had approximately 14 attacks with these types of substances.
Sin embargo, en países como Colombia,
nevertheless, in places like Colombia,
en el periodo de una década,
in the period of one decade,
se han registrado casi los 1,000 casos.
They almost registered 1,000 cases.
Razón por la cual el país sudamericano
and for this reason, this South American country
promulgó una ley para tipificar los ataques con ácido como un
they instituted a law to rate these crimes as
un delito grave,
a grave crime,
grave, y aplicar sanciones más severas a
and applying stronger sanctions
quien incurra en esta conducta,
whoever does incurs a crime using this conduct,
siendo las penas de entre 12 y 20 años de prisión,
and the terms of prison are usually between 10 and 20 years of incarceration,
y pudiéndose elevar hasta 40 años de cárcel para
and it could be elevated up to 40 years of jail or prison,
el caso que implique un daño permanente,
for those cases which imply a permanent or lifelong effect.
En lo que respecta a México, existen 10 estados en los que actualmente se regula esta conducta.
And in Mexico, there are 10 states which actually regulate this conduct.
Nuestra vigente legislación en el Código Penal Federal no hace ninguna alusión especial al uso de ácidos y sustancias corrosivas.
But generally, our legal department does not have special strict guidelines for these attacks with acid type attacks. Products,
dejando una gran laguna jurídica para la fiscalía y los
which leaves a great area of blindness in the judicial system,
jueces,
and for judges,
ya que el capítulo de lesiones solo determina lesiones en lo general,
because these lesions are only mentioned as general injuries,
sin especificar o tipificar
without specifying or typifying,
lesión ocasionada por sustancias corrosivas,
without mentioning lesions caused by corrosive agents.
Esto tiene como resultado la falta de otorgarle prisión preventiva oficial.
So this leaves as a problem the inability to give a strong case against people that are criminals in this area.
Ciosa. Y por consecuencia, vinculación a proceso al agresor.
And because of this, they are unable to use the processing or, you know, to cause them criminals or the aggressors to actually have charges brought against them.
lo que en la actualidad se determina en lo personal como un beneficio al agresor.
So this actually is considered a benefit to the aggressor.
Es pagar una sanción económica estipulada en la legislación actual.
And so usually they just pay some kind of a fine as a legal fee.
Por encuadrar en lesiones.
If they cause any lesions.
Que solo tardan 30 o 15 días en sanar.
And if these lesions start to heal within 15 to 30 days.
Dejando desprotegidas jurídicamente a las víctimas.
And this leaves the victims judicially unprotected.
A través de diversos medios de comunicación se han dado a conocer los casos de María del Carmen Sánchez.
And across the media we've had the known of the case of María. And he said the name.
María Elena Ríos.
María Elena Ríos.
Ana Elena Saldaña.
Ana Elena Saldaña.
Esmeralda Miñán.
Esmeralda Miñal.
Gloria Hernández, entre otras.
And Gloria Hernández, among others.
A continuación, me voy a permitir describir la terrible experiencia que vivió María del Carmen.
And he says, as we continue, I will give a description of the terrible situation which María del Carmen suffered.
Previo, durante y posterior al ataque.
Previous, during, and after the attack.
Ella llevaba una vida con su esposo inmersa en el maltrato.
She had been immersed in a life of physical abuse with her husband.
Y cuando decidió dejarlo,
and when she decided to leave him,
él tomó la decisión de agredirla con mayor grado de violencia.
He made the decision to attack her with a worse type of aggression.
Y marcarle de por vida.
And to mark her for life.
Fue en ese momento que le arrojó ácido sulfúrico a su rostro.
It was at that time that he launched sulfuric acid to her face.
Sellando con ello su dicho, si no vas a estar conmigo, jamás vas a estar con alguien.
And with that he sealed the saying, if you will not be with me, you will never be with anyone else, or no one will want you.
El ácido inmediatamente le carcomió la piel.
And so the acid immediately ate through her skin.
De su cara y gran parte de su cuerpo.
The skin on her face and a great part on her body as well.
Generando un dolor que era como si se quemara por dentro.
And it generated a pain which felt like she was burning inside.
Quedando desfigurada en cuestión de segundos.
And she was left disfigured in matter of moments or seconds.
Esta acción del esposo claramente lleva una premeditación.
And this behavior of the husband clearly showed premeditation.
Dolo, alevosía y ventaja.
And he had advantage.
Características que jurídicamente llevan un grado de gravedad.
And the advantage was that the legislator typically has a certain grade of related to the graveness of the crime.
No obstante lo anterior, María del Carmen enfrentó una lucha posterior al ataque en la búsqueda de justicia.
So after this crime, she suffered another problem, which was trying to find justice.
Y de atención médica.
And medical attention.
Misma que era difícil de recibir por la ausencia de conocimientos en el sector salud.
And that was difficult to, the health care was difficult to acquire because there was not really a lot of knowledge in the health sector.
Sobre este tipo de lesiones, aunado a la falta de sensibilidad de distintos funcionarios.
And so they're not really trained on how to treat this type of lesions with acid. And also the legislature didn't have basically how to treat or how to deal with these crimes.
Llegando al extremo de negarle procedimientos necesarios por considerarlos de carácter estético.
And so they denied her the judicial protection because they said it was just an aesthetic problem.
Sin embargo, al día de hoy se le han realizado más de 50 intervenciones quirúrgicas.
But as of now, she's had more than 50 surgical interventions.
Y su victimario sigue en libertad.
And her aggressor is still free.
Aprovecho este espacio para hacer un exhorto al secretario de salud del.
And so I take this opportunity to exhort to the Secretary of Health.
Gobierno federal.
Of the federal government.
Doctor Jorge Alcocer.
For Dr. Jorge Alcocer.
Para que pueda tomar en cuenta la especialización en este tipo de lesiones.
So that he could take into account the specialization of this type of lesions.
Puesto que me di cuenta que actualmente no contamos con protocolos de seguridad de salud en atención a las víctimas.
Because I realized that we do not have a protocol to attend, to give attention to victims.
De manera efectiva.
That is actually effective.
Es decir, contar con personal capacitado.
That is to be able to count with personnel that is capacitated or has been trained.
Tipo especializado.
With this specialized and also with this specialization and also the equipment necessary.
Y brindarles un tratamiento médico a las víctimas hasta donde sea necesario.
And to offer a treatment for these victims as far as it is possible.
Hoy extiendo mi más amplio reconocimiento a la valentía y perseverancia.
And today I extend my I don't know, to honor these women for their valor.
De todas las víctimas por la búsqueda de justicia y de.
For all these victims who search for justice.
Una legislación acorde al.
And to get legislation accordingly.
Daño provocado por este tipo de conductas.
To the date that is provoked by this type of conduct.
Y a todas las víctimas les digo, no.
And to all the victims I say,
no están solas.
You are not alone.
Y estoy convencido que esta legislatura, denominada de la paridad de género, aprobará este proyecto de decreto.
And I am sure that this new legislation, which is directed for gender crimes,
mediante el cual garantizaremos justicia,
with which we will guarantee justice,
justicia para las víctimas,
for the victims.
No vamos a permitir que se normalice esta atroz conducta.
We will not allow for this conduct that is atrocious to become normal.
Muchas gracias y todo mi reconocimiento antes de cederle el uso de la voz a Carmen por convertirse, obviamente por pasar por una desgracia común.
And he says thank you, and he's just announcing Carmen, who's going to be talking about her situation, and also, you know, to describe this case.
Una activista en la.
And now she is an activist.
Búsqueda de que se sancionen este tipo de conductas.
Who is searching to have these a type of conduct sanctioned.
Por ser perseverante, por.
And for her perseverance.
Para agrupar a las mujeres y a los hombres que han sido afectados.
By grouping the men and the women who have been affected.
Y pues bueno, nuevamente estamos aquí para servirte, Carmen, y te cedo el uso de la voz. Muchas gracias.
And he says, and again, we are here to serve you, Carmen, and I thank you for speaking.
Buenas tardes, soy Carmen Sánchez, víctima de agresión con ácido.
Okay, excuse me, I'm going to have to readjust this because she's a little bit shorter. So give me a second, I'm going to center that. It has to be readjusted. Oh, goodness gracious. Because she's so tiny, right? So, okay, I'm going to move this over. Give me just a second. We will adjust this. Okay. And let me see, the top needs to come down a bit. I am so sorry, but this is how you have to adjust these things in this situation here. Okay, so I'm gonna lock it up, and here we go.
Y activista por los derechos de las mujeres.
So let me go back just a tad to where she first comes on, because I don't know what she said. I was so distracted by the lack of her being in the center. Okay, there she goes. Right there. Okay.
Buenas tardes. Soy Carmen Sánchez, víctima de agresión.
And she says, good afternoon. I am Carmen Sánchez, victim of aggression.
Con ácido y activista por los derechos.
Victim of acid aggression, she's also an activist to
derechos de las mujeres.
For women's rights.
Estoy aquí por una sola razón.
And I am here for one reason.
Visibilizar el drama social que vivimos las mujeres hoy en día.
To bring out in the open to be seen the aggression that women are receiving.
Y porque se nos garantice una vida libre sin violencia.
And so that we can be guaranteed a life free of violence.
Quiero decir que no represento a ningún partido político y que
And I want to say that I do not represent any political party.
No he recibido ni un solo peso por estar aquí.
And I have not received a single bit of money for being here today.
Yo me represento a mí y al dolor de todas las mujeres.
I represent myself and the pain of all women.
Que han tenido que atravesar una situación como esta.
That have had to come across a situation like this one.
Una situación que se pudo evitar si el Estado cumpliera con sus obligaciones.
A situation which could have been prevented if the state would have complied with their legal obligations.
Antes de ser atacada con ácido, denuncié.
And before I was attacked with acid, I had made a complaint.
Y como yo, miles de mujeres más también denunciaron.
And like myself, many other women had complained about violence.
Los ataques con ácido en México no son un hecho aislado.
The attacks of acid attacks in Mexico are not an isolated incident.
¿Cómo van a ser un hecho aislado si hay una tolerancia social al machismo y una impunidad?
So how could they be an isolated case if there is a tolerance of machismo?
¿Dad institucional en la mayoría de los delitos?
And they are protected in most crimes.
Hace 6 días se cumplió un año del ataque.
6 days ago, it has been a year since, I mean, 6 days ago would mark the 1 year of the attack.
Con ácido a María Elena Ríos.
For the acid attack against María Elena Ríos.
Y gracias a la movilización de miles de mujeres y
And thanks to the mobilization of thousands of women.
Colectivas
and collective groups.
Haciendo justicia.
Who were searching for justice.
Fue que se logró vincular a proceso a 4 de los imputados.
And they were able to bring to justice 4 of the criminals.
De los implicados, perdón.
Or that had been implicated.
Entre ellos, Juan Antonio Vera Carrizal, ex
And among them, Juan Antonio Vera Carrizal,
diputado del PRI.
He was a deputy in the PRI party.
La última orden de aprehensión,
the last order of apprehension,
no se ha ejecutado,
has not been executed.
Actualmente, uno de los autores intelectuales,
actually one of the intellectual authors,
Juan Antonio Vera Hernández,
Juan Antonio Vera Hernández,
hijo de Juan Antonio Vera Carrizal,
is the son of Juan Antonio Vera Carrizal,
sigue libre, y
he continues to be free.
A más de un año de su agresión,
and it's been more than a year from his aggression,
en intento de feminicidio,
and an attempt for feminicide.
A María Elena Ríos.
To María Elena Ríos.
Yo misma sigo en espera de justicia.
And I myself am still waiting for justice.
Pues hace más de 6 años, 7 meses.
Because it's been more than 6 years and 7 months.
De mi agresión y las autoridades no han querido detener a mi agresor.
That since my aggression and the authorities have not wanted to bring to justice my aggressor.
Pero como dije, esto no es un caso aislado.
But as I said, this is not an isolated case.
Esta situación no es un caso aislado. Incluso cuando fue agredida Elena Ríos, los medios de comunicación dijeron que éramos solo 4 mujeres atacadas con ácido en el país.
And at the time that María Elena Ríos was attacked, the communication media said there was only 4 women in Mexico, in our country, that had suffered this type of aggression.
No es así.
And it is not the case.
En estos 6 años, 7 meses, yo he podido documentar.
In these 6 years and 7 months, I have been able to document
14 victims.
14 victims.
3 de ellas torturadas con ácido antes del feminicidio.
And 3 of them were tortured with acid before they were murdered.
Yo lo tengo muy claro.
To me, it is very clear.
Lo que no se nombra no existe.
That which is unnamed is said not to exist.
Todas estas mujeres no existimos para las autoridades.
And all of us women do not exist for the authorities.
Es la verdad.
That is the truth.
Por eso es que pasé de víctima activista por los derechos de las mujeres.
And that is why I went from victim to activist for rights for women.
Mi lucha y la lucha de las demás compañeras ya se empieza a escuchar.
And now my fight and the fight of my other companions is beginning to be heard.
Es por eso que ya hemos logrado tipificar los ataques con ácido en la Ciudad de México, Puebla, Oaxaca.
And for this reason, we have been able to typify the acts of aggression with acid in these states, Oaxaca. And she said something else, but I'm sorry, I forgot by the time I stopped it.
Y en el Estado de México.
And in the state of Mexico.
Y hoy estamos aquí en busca de reformar el Código Penal Federal.
And now we are here searching to change the federal penal code.
Para que se castiguen a los agresores.
So that aggressors can be punished.
Yo sé que estas leyes no van a ser retroactivas.
I know that these laws will not be retroactive.
Ni para mí, ni para ninguna de las mujeres que ya fuimos atacadas con ácido.
Neither for myself nor for any of the women that have suffered this.
Sin embargo, esto me da una gran tranquilidad de.
Nevertheless, this gives me a great tranquility.
Solo el hecho de saber que ninguna carpeta de investigación va a tener las mismas omisiones que la mía.
To know that no future file, legal file, will have the omissions that mine had.
Por supuesto que nada servirá con todas estas reformas.
But of course, none of these will work without any of these reforms.
Tan especiales que estamos haciendo.
With these special reforms we are trying to make.
Si las autoridades siguen mirando para otro lado.
If the authorities continue to look the other way.
Y mirar para otro lado implica que no reconozcan que los ataques con ácido son una forma de violencia de género.
And looking the other way would be to not recognize that attacks with acid are considered
género. Y una de
a violence against gender.
Las formas de violencia de género más devastadoras.
And it is one of the most devastating gender attacks
que existe.
That exists.
Que el 85% de las mujeres de
that 85% of the women
este país con las que yo he podido tener contacto y comunicación
the ones which I've been able to make contact with and communicate.
Son mujeres, que el 79% de los ataques de los atacantes son hombres.
And that 79% of the attackers are men.
Que casi todas las víctimas y el victimario se conocían y tenían una relación.
That most of the attackers and the victims were known to each other and had relations.
No mirar esto es negar también la impunidad institucional que
And not to look at this is also to deny the impunity, institutional impunity.
Que existe en la mayoría de los casos.
That exists in the majority of the cases.
El 64% de las mujeres seguimos en espera.
And 64% of the women are still in a state of waiting.
A que nos llegue la justicia.
So that justice will come.
Se nos repare integralmente el daño.
And so that they could repair the damages integrally that have been done to us.
Esta lucha no es una lucha mía.
This fight is not just my own.
Lucha es de todas las mujeres que hemos sido agredidas por estas sustancias corrosivas.
It is the fight of all of us women that have been attacked by these corrosive substances and aggression.
Esta lucha es por todas las mujeres de México, por las niñas de México y por
And this struggle is for all the women of Mexico, the little girls of Mexico.
Por todas las mujeres que vienen.
And all the women yet to come.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much. Wow, this really is unbelievably terrible. I mean, just the thought of how cruel, you know, this type of attack is. I had some other pictures I wanted to share with you. I looked up. This is one. Called Women of Valor, Acid Crimes. You can see these women had acid tossed on their face. Usually men have the intention of disfiguring to make them remember this forever, this crime against them. Here's another lady. This is from Wikipedia. This is an Iranian woman, acid attacked woman under treatment in 2018. So Wikipedia says acid throwing. That's where they throw acid attacks. Oh yeah, it's terrible. And then actually that might be something interesting for us to read. Let's see. Okay, an acid attack is also called acid throwing, vitriol attack, vitriolage, is a form of violent assault involving the act of throwing acid or similarly corrosive substance onto the body of another with the intention to disfigure, maim, torture, or kill. Perpetrators of these attacks throw corrosive liquids at at their victims, usually their faces, burning them and damaging their skin tissue, often exposing and sometimes dissolving the bones. Acid attacks can often lead to permanent blindness. The most common types of acid used is sulfuric, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid is sometimes used, but it's much less damaging. Aqueous solutions of strongly alkaline materials such as caustic soda, sodium hydroxide are used as well, particularly in areas where strong acids are controlled substances. So it scars, it's a horrible thing. This is another acid survivor trust. It's a worldwide problem of acid attacks. And you can see this map. It shows where, let me center this here. It shows where these attacks are prevalent. Okay, but now Mexico, you know, has a also. Let's see here. This man here attacked a man, actually.
61-year-old Clifton Blackwell in the acid attack that injured a Milwaukee man. Blackwell is facing one count of first-degree reckless injury with a hate crime enhancer. Police say Blackwell threw acid on Mahoud Villalaz outside a restaurant at 13th and Cleveland on Friday. A surveillance camera captured this incident.
According to the complaint, Blackwell confronted Villalaz about parking too close to a bus stop and stated, "Why did you invade my country and why don't you respect my laws?" The complaint says Villalaz called Blackwell a racist, and that's when he said Blackwell threw the acid. 12 News' Hillary Minch joins us now live. And Hillary, within the hour, Villalaz responded to the charge.
Anyway, you can see how horrible. I mean, and this one was caught on video, and this was an attack against a man. Now, the man was a man from Peru. And, you know, Peru is very close to my heart since I've got my friend, you know, that is Blanca Pasapera, and I have my friend who is Wilmer Dominguez Remar, and also I'm very respectful of Mr. Ricardo Belmont Casanelli, who is a great teacher. And these people from Peru are very gentle, sweet people. And just simply by him being a foreigner, he got this terrible attack caused on him. But I just wanted to show you how horrible it is, these attacks against women and men, of course. Now, you know, you can see it's not just men, but it is a worldwide problem. Here, let's see. This is a website, AST, which if you are wanting to know more about this, it shows a little bit of what the horrible damage that is done to women by these terrible crimes. And I think we really need to pay attention. It's in the US, laws are very much stronger regarding crimes that disfigure, but in the rest of the world it's not always the case. So this young lady here also was attacked, you know, and it's evident, you know, that she's still suffering and has not gotten justice. But I think we're making progress, and thanks to Andrés Manuel López Obrador having such generous heart and kind humanist heart, you know, seeking to help these women who have been had all these egregious acts against them, and actually taking a stance against it and pointing it out and bringing it out into the light. That's a big part of it, and it's something that makes the Mexican people very proud to have a president who actually cares about the people. Okay, well, that's what I saw today, and I thought I'd share it with you. Thank you very much, and have a great day.